Hi, and welcome to the premiere episode of Tech Talk. I'm Ken Mingus, executive editor at Computer World. I'm here with Brandon Butler from Network World, Mike Simon from Mac World, PC World, all kinds of consumer pubs.
Every world.
Every world, right. And Femina Rashid, who is in a remote location. We're here to talk about what's going on in technology today, the hot IT topics. We've got some news. We've got some fun things about the iPhone. We want to talk about how you interact with computers and why you're doing it wrong. But first, I wanted to start with Brandon because, you know, the newsiest thing we've got right now is Microsoft's recent announcement about Azure Stack.
Yes.
Okay. What is Azure Stack? I'm going to play dumb because I really don't always understand these things.
So in a nutshell, Azure Stack is Microsoft's private cloud offering. Right. And the reason this is a big deal is because Microsoft is one of the first companies to offer a private cloud that links up very closely with the public cloud.
Okay.
And so for a long time, since the advent of the cloud computing era, the holy grail of the cloud has been hybrid cloud computing. I don't want to move all of my workloads into the public cloud. I still want to have some of my workloads in my own data center behind my own firewall. But that's not really easy to do to create this hybrid cloud platform. And so all the way back in 2015, Microsoft talked about this Azure Stack.
Okay.
So Azure is the name of Microsoft's public cloud, and Azure Stack is meant to be a private cloud that is built on an infrastructure stack that you run in your data center on your own premises. And again, it's running the same software as what Microsoft is running in the public cloud.
So this is like having a version of Azure that is locally grown, basically.
Exactly.
On your premises. You don't have to. So the big issue here is, or the big plus here that Microsoft is trying to sell, is that you don't have to upload your data to the cloud and risk the security concerns that go with that.
Correct. Right? And so, but they're more pitching it as you don't have to upload all of your data to the public cloud. They still want you to use Azure public cloud.
Yeah.
But they say that for some information that's highly secure, highly sensitive, maybe for information or use cases where you don't have a connection to the public cloud because you're in the middle of the ocean, because you're on an oil rig or a cruise ship or something, you can't connect to the public cloud, then this Azure Stack can be a local private cloud that connects with that public cloud. Now, there's one other reason why this is really important is because when people think about the public cloud market on the infrastructure side, they think of three big players. Microsoft is one of them. Yep. Amazon Web Services is sort of known for inventing this market. And then Google has come up in recent years as being a major player in this market as well. And Google and Amazon don't have something like this.
I was just going to ask. So they're really first out of the gate. Microsoft is here.
They are, yeah. And like I said, they've been talking about this for almost 2+ years. And now it's finally coming to market. And Microsoft is really taking more of a hybrid cloud computing approach to this. Google and Amazon have much more of a public cloud-centric focus to their clouds. They talk much more about how companies are outsourcing their entire data centers, shutting down data centers, and moving all of their workloads to the public cloud. And Microsoft, for a long time, has talked about how it's a hybrid cloud world. But when they talk about hybrid, they talk about a Microsoft on both sides hybrid cloud equation.
So both public and
public and private.
And private,
yeah.
And then the hybrid.
Yeah.
In terms of pricing, because, I mean, obviously that's a big deal for companies if they're trying to figure out what they want to do. Has Microsoft announced any pricing on this?
They have, and they have their pricing on their website, which you can check out. I think the more interesting thing about pricing is not how much it actually costs, but how they are going to be pricing this. And they're going to be pricing it similarly to how folks use the public cloud, and that's a pay-as-you-go model. So when you buy Azure Stack, what you're doing is you're buying an infrastructure stack from one of three partners initially, Dell EMC, HPE, or Lenovo. So you get this infructure stack that has compute.
That's the hardware, basically.
The hardware, exactly. Yep. And then the software that runs on top of it, you only pay for what you use. So if you are using Azure Stack for virtual machines or storage, then you are not buying a whole subscription that you pay for annually and it's a set price. You're paying for it however much you use it, however many VMs you're running in Azure Stack, however much storage you're keeping in Azure Stack, that's how you pay for it. And they have a whole menu of other applications and services that run on top of Azure Stack, and those you only pay for when you use them. So you have this access to this whole library of applications that can run on Azure Stack, and you only pay for them when you actually spin them up. So that's a sort of unique pricing model as well.
Are businesses, are you buying the hardware? Are you you renting the hardware?
You are buying the hardware
okay.
From, like I said, the three initial partners, Dell EMC, HPE, and Lenovo. Soon Cisco and Huawei are also going to have offerings in this.
So you can't use your existing server setup and just kind of plug in as your
Really, yeah. Okay. This is probably going to require new hardware for folks to buy from one of these hardware vendors. And they're going to offer ongoing support for it as well. So it, one complicating thing with Azure Stack here is that you are going to have to sort of manage two relationships, one with your hardware vendor, the Dell EMC, HPE or Lenovo, and one with Microsoft, who's going to be selling you the software.
Yeah, because I mean, the benefit, what I see the benefit of cloud offerings is that you're guaranteed to have the best hardware. It's going to work. It's going to work fast. You don't have to deal with an old, outdated server. It's constantly updated, and that's what you're paying for. You're paying for Microsoft to say, all right, you know, we're promising you that we're going to deliver this stuff as fast as humanly possible.
Exactly. Yeah, you're paying for them to do all the legwork, all the hard work of managing the infrastructure.
So what happens in 3 years? Like, say you buy Azure Stack. What happens in 3 years when your chip and your server is old?
That's a downside of Azure Stack. And I think that's why Amazon and Google are saying, don't worry about the private cloud. Just send everything to the public cloud because we are going to upgrade all that infrastructure for
It'll
you.
It'll be safe. There'll be nothing to worry about.
Why not?
Brandon, with the Azure Stack, with the private cloud offering, you mentioned that Microsoft is going to be running the Azure software, the same one as public. Is that being maintained by Microsoft, or is that the enterprise that now has to figure out how to maintain the Azure software?
Yeah, so Microsoft says that they will maintain the software, and there's two important components to that. So they have regular software updates that are going to be shipped to Azure Stack, and customers have a choice of when they actually implement those. So if you're a shop that likes to update frequently, then you can do this as much as you want, and you will stay as up to date as Microsoft is going to be able to. With the Azure Public Cloud. And then what they're also going to be doing is shipping a once-a-month security and hardware updates. So these are going to be done through your hardware vendor, and they say they're going to incorporate all the latest security patches and bug fixes, stuff like that.
It makes me wonder, though, if you're trying to coordinate. You know, the first thing I thought of when you said that was Android, because you have to worry about those patches being rolled out from the hardware vendors. I mean, so, you know, let's hope that the hardware vendors are rolling them out on a regular basis, just as Microsoft would expect you to roll them out.
Yeah.
I didn't mean to. Did you have other questions for me? I didn't mean to.
I mean, that was kind of my thought also. Like, it's hard enough staying on top of patching and updating, and then now it looks like we're making it slightly more complicated by relying on hardware vendors, on Azure, as well as my schedule. So it just seems like we've actually complicated the process a little bit.
Yeah,
it may be complicated, and that's why this solution may not be one for everyone. Right. You know, I talked to a couple analysts this week who follow the cloud market closely, and they say that this, while it's much heralded and has been talked about for 2 years, they say this is probably not going to be something that everyone is going to use. But for those use cases where people have stuff that they absolutely do not want to ship into the public cloud, but for some reason they want it to run on the same software stack as what's running in the public cloud, then this is an answer for that. So
it does feel like there's a certain niche here. You know, obviously Microsoft is making a play for a narrow niche of companies for which this might be useful. You know, it occurs to me too, though, if you're doing pay as you go, you're going to have some way to monitor how much you're spending. You know, because if you're not keeping tabs on that,
challenge.
that can blow up in a very short time.
Runaway virtual machines that don't get turned off, and storage that you have up there that you don't actually need. There's a whole market of cloud management tools that do that stuff for customers, and that's a fast-growing market.
I'm sure, for obvious reasons.
The main idea of the stack is that it would be seamless to switch from private to public and go back and just easily turn things off, turn things on, and as you need them.
Okay. Yep.
So, I mean, I can see the appeal to a certain but a very specific business model here.
Yeah, but I mean, you think about it, and how many people do you run into who say, well, I like the public cloud in theory, but I'm not ready to use it because of XYZ. Because
security, usually.
Security, regulations, I have these customized apps that I've been using that have been developed specifically for me. And I think Microsoft is trying to appeal to that clientele who, you know, like the idea of cloud, but don't want to ship all their data up into the public cloud.
Right. Is Azure Stack available now?
So
what's the time frame?
So you can order it now, and it will be shipping in the fall. Okay. So it's coming soon.
Yep, okay.
But yeah, the big news last week was that you can finally start ordering it. And this, again, is 2 years after they first announced it. Okay. So, and I'm going to be very interested to see how Microsoft's biggest competitors here, Amazon and Google, how they respond to this. Amazon just last year made a big announcement with VMware, partnering with them. So does that relationship deepen because of this? Google partnered with a company named Nutanix. Does that partnership get deeper? Like, sort of what are the ripple effects of this Azure stack will be really interesting to watch.
I mean, the one thing is both Amazon and Google are not primarily hardware based.
Exactly.
So I would assume they'll just double down on their software, on their, you know, their,
yeah,
their virtual
versions. And they're going to have to find hardware partners to sort of to address this problem.
And convince them they know what they're doing with that hardware, too.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, Microsoft has a history here. They know, you know.
But
well, you'll be tracking this, though, to see how this rolls out and which companies might be taking it up.
I sure will. Yeah. Good. Yeah. And yeah, it'll just be really interesting to see. It's an interesting. It's like I said, it's been sort of hyped up a lot in the cloud market, and now people are actually going to be able to get their hands on it this fall. So it'll be interesting to watch.